Hey there, yeah, welcome to my fifth part of my seventh attempt at 21% single segment. I'm close to get the artifact of spirit, and let's just continue. Getting Skywalk here. Yep. So the second last door transition here. Okay, I made it. Where's the door? Door's about here, right? Yeah. Okay, finding the corner. Come on, where's the corner? Lost at the jumps of the whole run. Hey, don't shoot at me, fucking bastards. Oh fuck. Still too close. Well, get the fuck out of here. This one will die. Yeah. Okay, got it. Finally. This walk crawl is always just 1 hour or 1.5 hours that, the game takes longer. It's really just... Wow, it takes fucking long. Now let's just see if I can get this to work. Whoa. Okay. Almost, I guess. But it's possible. And I made a video of it. Now what's actually left? Oh, 6 artifacts, okay. Well. Yeah, in Artifact of World in Hall of the Elders, Artifact of Sun in Chapel of the Elders. Artifact of... Oh, I thought it was wild, oh my god, would have been bad. Artifact of Lifegiver in Tower of Light. Chamber. Yeah, something like that. Artifact of Strength in Monitor Station. Artifact of Elder in Control Tower. And Artifact of Truth. Okay. Cool, with this route you don't even have to do those last two quite difficult bomb jumps in Frozen Park, because you can just... Well, because you don't do Twin Fires and Twin Fires Tunnel anyway, so... You can just do it this way. Okay. Better kill him now. So that I won't, for sure, won't die in control to fucking pirates. Okay. Okay, 5 artifacts missing. As always, just go here first, then take out the first three and then the next two and the last two. So, whoa, what happened with this one? Don't risk anything with those scarabs, because they are evil, very, very evil. Okay, fail. This is literally the easiest triple bomb jump there is. I mean, it can't be done with a double bomb jump, but there's so much place for leeway. You can just... yeah. You can't fuck it up, but it's really easy not to fuck it up. Just always go to the head of the statue, because jump double bomb jump from here to here is really easy, so yeah. Just do it this way. Oh, come on, you can just jump. Okay, 4 artifacts missing, and none of them in Phase and Minds of Windrunner Drifts, yay. Just thinking about which artifacts again were missing. Yeah, of course, strength, which I'm going to get right now. Oh, life giver, exactly. And artifact of world. Okay, that's it. The remaining two artifacts in Chozo Ruins, the remaining one in Magma Caverns, and of course, the artifact of truth, red. Yeah, right. 1, 2, 5, and 10. That's bad. That's like really bad. Well, no, seriously, that just no, that no, that can't be. there has to be like something to dash off, right? Yeah, those, but. Does it work? Oh god. Come on. Oh god, it's possible. Oh god, if it wasn't possible, I would have had to wall crawl. Or to risk dying and just. Well, wall crawling is also risking to die, but. It would have been possible, like, to dash off one of the flying pirates. Thank you. ice parade here. Oh. Long time ago I picked up this item last time. Okay, 3 artifacts missing. The 2 in Chosen Ruins. And... 1. 1 I already have, which is of course the artifact of Wild, which would be very hard compared to just beating Flagra and Infinite Bomb jumping your way back. Okay, I think it might be faster if you were to pull it off perfectly, but just wanted to show. No one's going to see this exact thing I just did anyway, I guess, yeah. Okay, no, really, getting the artifact of Wild would be... Yeah, you can do it the easy way. Or you just... Well, you could get from... For example, from... Gathering Hall, just Velcro to here. Yeah, would suck. Mainly because, no, not mainly, but getting into the Gathering Hall secret world is not too easy. Especially for the first time, and well, I already did it 3 times to get certain items in Chosen Ruins that I couldn't get before on my 21% upgrade conditions max percent run. So I just picked up 74 items. Oh, percent of items, and I didn't have space jump, boost ball, spider ball, charge beam, super missile, gravity suit, grapple beam, or thermal visor. Just none of those items you don't get under in a 21% items. Okay, now going to take out those ghosts first. Fucking ghosts. Okay. This is just an alternative I came up with on my first 21% playthrough. And I think it's a decent amount easier than doing this weird H half-pipe bomb jump from here to here and then dash from here to here, because we could just get here and then dash there on this thing. It's not too easy not to fall off or to slip off that that, what's it, an incline, this one there. So yeah, just make sure you press L, oh, come on, at the right time, and that you bend the dash a bit backwards. Just always jump here and everything's works fine. Just the artifact of the world in Hall of the Elders, and that always happens for some reason. And yeah, of course, the artifact of truth missing. This item here you can actually get without boost ball and without space jump if you do a bomb jump that is like the one in Ventshaft. It's not too hard but not too easy either, so yeah, just practice and you will get it. Probably a good practice if you haven't done Ventshaft yet and yeah, just want to practice. So, and now, reading this, the path of corruption leads even higher for the, for the like, fifth time, I guess. Doesn't even take so long to get those last remaining 6 artifacts if you those that are easy to get and not dangerous, I mean. Yeah, it's like it saves time overall to get those items as late as possible. In real time, I mean, because you'll end up losing, if you're as crazy as me, attempting 21% single segment, and yeah, you'll just get it like 1 out of 10 times. And yeah, you'll die often. And if you just collect all the artifacts that you don't really need, like this one, which is not dangerous, not hard. It's hard, but not dangerous, and not so hard as, for example, the artifact of Shoso. So just get it at the end, if you make it that far. Oh, come on. Goal is of course to get like here and then jump here. So no, not jump, but yeah, like this. So get with enough momentum, get into there. Then you'll just bump away and then try to control this and use it to your advantage. Some reason that almost always happens if you try to. One more here. Okay, got it. Yeah. Now comes the fun part, which I usually mess up. Yeah. At least I got to get a double bomb jump in the first place, but. Just hold to your right as far as possible after you have dashed into that like into that part just next to it. Wait, what? Did I like get accelerated by this knob? By this like thing here? Strange. I got it and slipped off because I held too much on the right as I was already on that platform, on that tiny platform. Really not so good at this because getting the artifact of world requires you to like get the setup. Yeah, learn it by heart, but I just like seem to forget it. So I seem to forget what exactly I have to do. Okay, so that I was like. I got upwards momentum. Oh, come on. Oh, that was tight. That's close. Ah, come on! It's the fourth time I messed it up. Clippers. Oh, I thought I fell down. Oh god, fifth time. That was a very crazy upwards momentum, you saw that. I just happened not to find the knob I had to land on. Wow. There was another one of those dash jumps with an incredible upwards momentum, but I, because of that, I didn't happen to find the knob. Okay, come on. Sixth time I landed this fucking knob. Oh, come on. That has happened to me the last three times. Just fell off. Thank you. Come on. Yeah, I'm not too sure though if it was the last three. Yeah, well, doesn't matter. Wow, three continuous times. Okay, come on. God, it's three continuous times. I mean the dash. This is the same as in MQA, Metroid Quarantine A. If you were safe after you had pulled off one of those tricks. And those tricks aren't very hard alone, but yeah, it's a different story because you have to do it all in one. That's the main problem of Great Tree Hall and Fendrana's Edge, that make it to the hardest two rooms. I mean, Geocore doesn't count, so Great Tree Hall is the hardest room. Basically, Observatory would be even harder because it's impossible even with Boost Ball. Varies, yeah, with Boost Ball, Geocore is theoretically possible, but only theoretically. And Fendrana's Edge is more or less doable, but still, no one except Tisri has done it. I could do it, I know, and some other guys, I think, but just don't have the patience right now for this. Oh god, the 8th time or so that I messed this up. Come on. What was that? Okay, that was a weird dash. Yes. Okay, finally. Sometimes this just like takes me 5 minutes, and sometimes it takes me like, yeah, even longer than now. Okay, come on. Yeah, just artifact of truth missing. I know I could go like the way of Forgot the Crash Site, but I don't want to. Because there's that missile explosion there. And as you can see, I've never been to Forgot the Crash site ever in this run. And also I've never been... Oh, I've actually been to Twin Fires and Twin Fires Tunnel, but just like in my... during my wall crawl of... during the wall crawl to Plasma Beam. Enough. It's weird to go the to cross this room backwards, isn't it? Oh, weird. This run is going to be like 8 hours long, right? Oh god. Beetle Dash. Not going to save. Back to the ship and reload so I can reload my ammunition, yeah, right, and get this missile back. At least it would be faster if there was that cutscene. At least I guess it's faster to use that scan post. This is a chosen artifact. Collect it and scan the target. does his attack he did, his second attack in orbital. Then just wait a bit, log forward, jump, wait a bit more. Recap after Omega Pirate, or before Omega Pirate, I was saved again. So this is basically Angels. Few damage as possible. No. If he doesn't even use his laser, it's not too bad actually. Just make sure if you're on full health, just don't lock. Then you're like on 70 health, or yeah, 60. Was pretty close, crazy. And yeah, then the god, I so much damage. This is so dramatic because I don't really take any damage at all. As long as I haven't taken damage, I'm not so nervous actually. But as soon as I have. So, you all know he has got 3 units of health plus 3 units of health after he has gotten really angry. So, this is about occasionally you just do it like with missiles and missile him to death. But without charge beam and with just 5 missiles, you have got to do it a bit different. It's also the fastest method, but also the best and the most safe. You can just, as I have done in the first phase where he's not too angry, you can just use plasma beam, and then you've got 5 missiles for 5 subforms. Problem is, it might happen that one missile doesn't hit him, or that it hits him, but then he's invulnerable because of some strange bug or glitch, and then you've basically wasted the missile. So, even though in a speedrun you would now just use your 5 missiles against those last 5 subforms, just don't do it and do one more with plasma beam so that you have one extra missile. Because when he is angry and his last 3 subforms are really even harder than his first 3 subforms on the ground form, I'm just talking about the ground form. And so just do one more with the plasma beam. Might also be that with now I have got one extra missile, so I've got 4 missiles for 3 subforms. And it might be that A, he's invulnerable due to a glitch or bug or something, and that the missile is wasted, or B, that the missile doesn't even hit him, which would be clearly a mistake of yours, or C, which is the most likely, next to A. Just B is unlikely, but A and C, just that he's invulnerable to a bug or glitch, or C, that you don't get enough plasma beam shots and the subform hasn't been finished correctly. So subform, you know how that works. Then you stun him again and just one or two more plasma beam shots and then the subform will be finished. So just always save one extra missile. Just do it like I do, and rewatch if you're not sure. Wait, just get 10 health back. Then get your missile stock to 5. Oh, and by the way, just kill all of them so that you have maximum health. XP, I guess, index level P, oh yeah, so, you this is another one of those very easy UBJs that just can't be cleared. With a double bomb jump, but with even with a HBJ, which is better against a wall. Even with a HBJ, you can more or less easily make it. Okay, now somewhat, yeah, well, quite difficult double bomb jump. It's very close, but since it's just a double bomb jump and not a UBJ, can't do so much wrong. So can't do so bad. Just a few things you've got to pay attention at. So. Okay, with HBJ it's not too easy. Same goes for reflecting pool. Come on. But reflecting pool, I guess, is easier with my bomb space charm method. Oh god, I did. Yeah, I guess a reflecting pool is easier if you do it with my method and not the HJ or UBJ method. It's also possible to get from the last platform to here with a double bomb jump, which is required for the European or PAL version. But then this double bomb jump is even harder than the double bomb jump for the last platform. So the hardest thing you can do in the Euro that is required not paying the total control, because if you're not
really bad. That thing didn't work. Because it was just like attempting to beat this boss. Actually the only one on subjump 2 that the only phase during which the only phase during which you can summon those. Just make sure you start with 99 unit advantage or almost 99 against subchamber. So when you get into subchamber 3, this is kinda really make sure that now you don't lose. Don't dash them. That's what killed me in my first 20% attempt. Because I was like here on the right side. Oh yeah, behind me. You can imagine right on the other side. So I'm now in the middle. And imagine I was on the back side of subchamber 4. Yeah, it was in subchamber 4 where I died. And then I just couldn't like dash. And I'm sure you guys know about this, sometimes you just can't dash if you like, if the ground is very uneven. If the ground is just kinda uneven, then you should always be able to dash, but somehow on September 4, I happened not being able to dash 3 times in a row and got died. On my first ever 21% single second attempt, and I never died during this attempt, so it would have been my first attempt, which would have been the world record. But it is the world record because, no one has ever gotten it so far. Because T3 died against Meta Ridley, and just I died. Like, because I was so far away from him. Rift Draws are, if you're very close to Metroid Prime, he can do damage to you with his claws. With his arms. Let's just say tentacles or arms. And then he can damage you, but as long as you're very close to him, the rockets won't they won't hit you. Which is good. But of course you've still got to be this is where a missile is very important. You saw that? I wouldn't have had enough time to like knock out this orb. Just fly like crazy. Make sure he doesn't have any time to summon orbs. If he summons orbs, or he is about to summon orbs while their while you like set his HP to zero, then you've got a problem because this orb won't damage you. If you like finish subchamber 1, you will automatically be in subchamber 2 during the cutscene, or get into subchamber 2, but you can't get damaged. But here you will be still be in subchamber 4, not in subchamber 5, which is the problem, and this is why you can get why those fucking orbs can kill you after you have just lowered his HP to zero. Okay. Just makes sure you play slowly and then. Oh god. Thing is, as soon as there are Talon Metroids, the easy ones, the most easy ones to kill, you can just knock out those and preferably with an ice beam shot, on the second one while they are still close together, and then one missile so that both go dead, in like same time. But just make sure now you don't go for the pool and try to damage it, because it will be invisible because you don't have thermal visor. And since this is not a speedrun at all, it's no freaking speedrun, I won't do any damage to it while it's in the pool. Come on, where is it? Get to the left. Come on, where's the pool? The fuck's going on here? Come on. that's cool. Come on, come on. Yes. Got a bit. You see, now I'm at full health again. Okay, I'm not sure if there are now fish no metroids or cold metroids. Of course, fish no metroids are less bad than hunter metroids. Okay, I got them. I have to make sure I don't get too much. Just be around here, in this fort. Yeah, like it's a circle, right? Like be between here and here, because here you can't get the ult damage. Two pools left, perhaps. First now, hit me, which is pretty cool. Yeah, it's dead. Okay, wow, that was my 1 death, 21% single segment attempt where I just died once against Omega Pirate and then restarted from the Metroid Quarantine B safe station and finished the game with one death in total under exact 21% single damage. Still did damage.
Holy crap! I have to say, this was not an economic run, because it's now Sunday and I started this playthrough on Thursday. That means I played on Thursday, let it play all night, played on Friday, let it play overnight, played on Saturday and let it play overnight and played on Sunday, which is today. And yeah, that's just because I wanted it to be a single segment attempt and not like, I don't know, we all know it's silly, but it's the rules, right? have to, like, we can't just set our consoles to off and then play single segment on the next day when you have got enough time, you know? It's silly because it's not economic. Yeah, but occasionally though you play single segment in like 1 or at maximum 2 days and not at 4 days. And yeah, just didn't have time yesterday. Because I wanted to record my run and upload it to YouTube, of course. And yeah, my father and my brother had to go onto my laptop yesterday, so... Wow! What a cool guess! I guessed it was like 8 hours, and it's like 8 hours. Cool. No. So, let's see. I'm pretty sure I've never saved after Metroid Quarantine just before Omega Pirate. Then I died once against Omega Pirate, and then I restarted from Metroid Quarantine B safe station and made my way all, yeah, well, to the credits without ever dying again. And so I'm like 4 hours, 4 hours 48, right? Correct. You can, yeah, you remember that? Just go to, this is part 5, go to part 3 at pretty much at the end. No, it's not, no, it's actually not at the end, it's about 2/3 on the run of part 3 of this attempt. And then you'll see how I died against Omega Pirate with very bad luck, and yeah. Then I hope you learned something, and yeah, you can trust me, it's really just, it's honestly one death. And besides that one death, it was a proper 21% single segment demonstration. I hope you guys enjoyed and learned something. If you have questions, just ask me, I can pretty much answer, well, all your questions that are meant seriously. And focusing on what's the game about, or what's 21% about. And yeah, just leave a comment and tell me if you're interested. And yeah, have a good day. Bye.